ladies and gentlemen, is a typical modern-day shul.
What? This is a shul? Yeah. This is where people come to pour their hearts out to Hashem? No one's even davening.
Something must be done. We must get them to understand the beauty of tefillah.
Where do we even begin?
How about we start with the Siddur?
No, tefillah began even before the times of the Siddur. We must go further back, way back to the times of the Beit HaMikdash, a time of peace, happiness, and harmony. A time before these cell phone contraptions or text messaging. The nation used to bring daily korbanot to the Beit HaMikdash, the korban tamid.
That's right. This is where we get the idea of tefillah, to parallel the daily korbanot that were brought during the times of the Beit HaMikdash.
Wait, I thought we got the idea from the Avot.
Well, yes. The Gemara in Brachot gives two possible places from which tefillah was instituted, one being the korbanot and the other being the Avot.
In fact, doesn't the first bracha of Shemoneh Esrei talk about the Avot?
Yeah, good point. The Avot introduced the concept, but you should know the role of another ancestor, Chana. She gave us the heart and feelings of the idea, and also some laws of tefillah. Like one should daven in a whisper, hey, I have an idea, let's walk these people through the Shemoneh Esrei and show them the power of tefillah.
Oh my God, look at that guy. He looked like he's dead.
Help! Someone call 911! Quick!
What? 911? What is that? Someone call Hashem! Call Hashem! Hashem, please save this boy!
Thank God.
Wow! Did everyone just see that? Tefillah just brought this boy back from the dead. This is the second bracha in Shemoneh Esrei, Techiyat HaMetim, where we praise Hashem's ultimate strength, including his powers of bringing the dead back to life. If that's not a clear sign of the power of tefillah, I don't know what is.
That's amazing, but that kind of thing doesn't happen every day. Is davening just for these real emergencies, life or death situations? I kind of want to see some more.
Wait, everybody stop for a second.
What?
Why? Shh. Everybody, look up now.
Oh man, I just got the chills. It's so holy up there.
Okay, everyone slowly move forward. We don't want to disturb the angel.
But wait, do we ever get to say those praises? Do we ever get to be like the angels?
Depends. When you are by yourself, you cannot reach the level of an angel and borrow their prayers. But when you're in a group, you get to take the angels' praises and make them your own. We are going to make your name kadosh, just like the angels do in the heavens.
That was inspiring. But prayer, we can't just borrow the prayer of the angels. Their prayers won't help me in the jam that I got myself into today. I got my math test back. My mom's gonna be so mad. I got a 62.
That's rough.
You're in luck. The first section of Shemoneh Esrei was about praising Hashem, Shevach. That's when we borrow the praises of the angels. But the next section of Shemoneh Esrei is known as Bakasha. And that's when we are supposed to ask Hashem for help in all the different situations in our lives. The very first bracha is the one that could have helped you on your math test. Chonein Hada'at. Please give us wisdom and understanding and insight.
Wow, I wish Yeriah could have been in September, so I would have known that before my first math test. And are you sure this works? Do you know people whose requests for wisdom were actually answered?
Of course! Just look to the right and you'll see the God-given wisdom of Shlomo at work. Right after Hashem bestows wisdom upon Shlomo, Shlomo is able to perceive the truth and resolve all debates. And then he became known the wisest judge in all the lands.
It's my baby.
No, it's my baby.
It's my baby.
Ladies, give me the child. Servant, get me a sword. I will cut him in half, and you should each have a piece.
You keep the baby. I don't want him to get hurt.
The child is obviously yours, for you care for its well-being.
Wow, I hope one day I can be as smart as him.
Keep davening, and one day all of you can be. You, ma'am, you look as though you're nearly there. Keep up the good work.
Hey, I saw that. There's no ceiling in the first school.
Oh man, you're in trouble. You better ask for forgiveness from Hashem.
Oh man, I'm so ashamed.
Good.
Good? That's good.
Yes, that's the first step in doing teshuva. You must regret your actions and be ashamed, and the next step is coming up on you right now. Ask for forgiveness from Hashem.
It's okay. I'm just kidding. We do that in Shemoneh Esrei right after we ask for wisdom. Once we are given wisdom, we must look at our actions and see what needs improvement. We ask that Hashem help us to do teshuvah, and we ask that he forgives us for our sins. We've been doing it for years. It's basically part of our national history.
Please, Hashem.
And it worked.
Forgive them.
The people were forgiven. Tefillah worked. And it works for anything you're struggling with. In the next bracha of Shmona Esrei, we ask that God help us with any struggles we have. Look at our struggles and fight our battles.
But because health is such a basic need for everyone, it has its own bracha, Refa'inu.
And it's automatic. As soon as we daven, bam, people get better. So then why have I been taking all these gross medicines all these years?
Tefillah certainly helps, but you must do whatever you can on your own. But sometimes not even medicine works, and then we must completely rely on our tefillahs alone. For example,
Hell no, fanala.
Five words, that's all? Amazing. Does this work for something like money and presents also? God, make him give me money.
Tefillahs don't always work right away, and they also need your involvement and efforts as well.
Okay, I'll get involved. Hey, can I buy $5?
Maybe you shouldn't be asking people for money. We're in a recession, you know.
Recession? I've heard about that. That's the reason we have those nasty cardboard cereals for breakfast,
well,
right?
Well, maybe if everyone concentrated on the bracha of Mivarech HaShanim instead of talking to each other about what was on Gossip Girl last day, you could have some Fruit Loops instead of Tutti Frutti's.
Hey, don't judge me. I don't even watch Gossip Girl. Hey, look, a chair.
No, wait, don't sit. That chair is not for you.
What? What was that?
That was the shofar, Gadol Acherotenu. At this point in tefillah, we have already finished asking God about our personal needs. And now we ask him to help us out as a nation. The shofar represents the beginning of this process.
Oh, I thought that was just for Rosh Hashanah.
You're not so far off. The first thing we ask for following that shofar Gadol is that Hashem take the throne of justice, just like he does on Rosh Hashanah. And we ask that he punish the wicked and then reward the righteous.
Guys, I'm going to go to the king. You must daven for me and fast for 3 days. It's the only way to save the Jewish people.
Yeah!
Whoa, what's going on over there?
This is Esther. During her time as queen, Haman arose and tried to kill out all of the Jews. But we daven that Hashem should destroy the wicked and the slanderers and save us. Shover oyvim v'chnia zedim.
So every day in Shmona Esrei, we mention those who tried to bring us down and thank Hashem for always having our back.
But we don't only talk about the bad people. We also mention all the good people. They're very important, too.
What more could we ask for after rewarding Tzaddikim? Oh, I know what's coming next. Mashiach and rebuilding the Beit HaMikdash.
Right, but in the reverse order. First, we discuss the rebuilding of Yerushalayim, restoring its glory. And then, the coming of Mashiach, which in Shmona Esrei is compared to a plant.
A plant? Isn't Mashiach supposed to be exciting and dynamic? I had a plant once, but I threw it out. After 6 days, it wouldn't grow. I watered it every day, but it just wouldn't grow.
That's exactly it. The Geula is like a plant's growth, slow but constant. Always there, but barely noticeable.
And you don't throw it out after a few days, although sometimes it can be frustrating.
Well, that's gotta be it. What else could there be after Mashiach?
A snow day. A cancellation of school the day after Shiria, because we've all worked so hard.
Please.
That's what Shema Kolenu is for. It's that Hashem should want to answer any prayer, whether for the nation or for the individual, big or small. It shows us that Hashem really has control over everything in our lives, even the really small things.
Please save the injured Chayalin. Oh, that's a good one.
What else can we ask for?
That's it.
Okay, thanks so much for the tour.
Wait. Thanks. Did you say? You anticipated the final section of Shmona Esrei, Hoda'ah, the thanks for listening. And thanks for the help you give us all the time, Erev, Avoker, Vitzaharayim.
Hey, a comic. I love comics.
That's no ordinary comic. It describes the scenes of the morning, the Birchot HaShachar, regular everyday miracles we thank Hashem for.
And before you go, we just wanted to leave you with a blessing.
I want to thank you, really, for teaching me about all these tefillot. I understand the idea and the progression much better now.
From the four corners of the world, wherever a Jew may find him or herself, he or she directs his prayers to the Beit HaMikdash. In fact, at every minute of the day, there is probably a Jew davening somewhere in the world. As a nation, we have an ongoing conversation with Hashem.